our website, but of course you have to get to all of them.
To get to them.
Yeah, I mean, we can.
And just the question you said about.
It's really so intuitive though, and there's a button that says sign up or sign in, so, you know, like if you click that, it's gonna take you through everything.
Do you have to be a parent in the district to sign up?
No, but there's no confidential information in there, but for example, there's a link to My School Box and there's, but there you have to have your account, so.
And then as far as teacher updates, I know in the past that was always an issue, and teachers using email and whatnot of contract issues. Are they going to be required to update and do it on a timely basis besides the teachers, the guidance office, the other various offices to make sure what's there is current?
We are strongly encouraging people to do that. The example that I've been giving, because I think it's real, is that if you needed somebody's telephone number, would you go to the Yellow Pages or would you go to the internet? And if you're going to the internet, it's logical that you also allow parents to be informed in the same way. So if you're not, you know, finding the Yellow Pages and flipping through it to look for a phone number that you require, if you are using the internet to be, you know, productive, and then you should allow. Then you should extend the same courtesy. So we've been very pleased at the participation already. The other part of that, and we've been having this conversation for a year already, is that if you want parents to be your partners, then you need to keep parents informed. So you know, I think people understand that. I think people see how easy the website is. There will definitely be variations of use. There's already people that have videos up there, and I mean, they've gone to town with this thing. And then there's others that have the basic information up there. So, you know, just like anything, there's gonna be variation of use, but we created two templates, an elementary template and a secondary template for teachers. So we've actually made it very easy for them to just pull the template in and fill that out. So it's about the teacher and things like that.
Another concern, obviously, is a parent going through the college process the second time is getting the guidance of current college visits, current, you know, done 2 years, 3 years ago doing this, nothing was current in that section. Mm-hmm. And it was very challenging to find, you know, what schools are coming. You know, honestly, you know, you have to remind the kid, oh, so-and-so's coming, go sign up for that. But as far as the forms and things like that, it's not much. Scholarship information.
And guidance has its own page, so every department has its own page, including guidance, and there's somebody that is in charge of the high school to keep that.
But that's a huge area, too.
But when you make it easy to do, it's more likely to be done.
I'll let you know.
Don't you worry.
Well, let Sheila know.
Yeah,
she volunteers.
She's a community. She is.
She's a lot more techie than I am, so, but she'll let me know. Actually, one other thing, sorry, just a quick thing. The academies sound awesome, but I know the challenge with the other academies, if you're a music student, you cannot do the academies or art students. If they're, and I know it's been looked at, but I know if,
and this year,
going
into next school year, and there were, I think, 5 students where there was a conflict.
Okay. I know, and it got, obviously, my kids are older, but in the beginning, you know, neither of them could even think about it.
But we looked at that this year.
Art.
We brought somebody in to sort of be another set of eyes on the master schedule, and I believe that we ended up with 5 kids that had a conflict.
Yeah, and obviously as it goes on, I know, like again, my kids are older, but the encouragement was, oh, you're a band student, you can't do it. Mm-hmm.
What
it does
was,
that mean?
You know. What does it mean there was a conflict? They can't do it, or you found a way to work through the conflict?
For many of them, we found a way to work through the conflict. So depending upon where you place things, you know, band, for example, might be one period in the day. And if you place band in the same period as you place, you know, like a medical academy class that is only offered one time, it creates a problem. But, you know, part of the challenge is lunch, you know, the lunch periods in the middle of the day, most of us in high school schedule in the morning. And, you know, and the placement of singletons. So. You know, so we watch that, but it you know, we, and we, I think, did a good job this year of making sure that we minimize the conflicts. but, you know, as you grow up, there are decisions you have to make in life. And so, you know, as we look at our academy programs too, one of the things that is really sort of coming to life is that across the academies, there are classes that we can offer that it doesn't matter which academy that you're in. So for example, in the New Media Academy, whether you choose to go into the medical sciences, or you go into law and government, or you're in global business, there are new media departments in every one of those, in everything. You know, there's, I mean, Christina is our new media department involvement, and every place has that. So no matter what your academy you're in, you know, making that class available, you know, like a writing for new media class, making that available should cut across academies. And I think the more that we do that, the more successful we're going to be at minimizing what the conflicts are. So, you know, we have our eye on that, we're watching that. I can't say that there won't be any conflicts. But again, you know, the creation of new academies and the refinement of the existing academies is all about two things. It's about our kids, and it's about where their job's going to be, and really developing those academies around where the jobs are going to be.
Thank you.
Yes. Hi, Lori Fitzpatrick, 2284 Marquette Avenue. I just want to say thank you. After having children in the school district since 1998 at Meadow, Kelly just graduated this year. I was just very pleased with both their educations, their treatment, the board has done a fabulous job. And this year, especially with Kelly's graduation, the class of 2015 as compared to the class of 2014, they were fabulous. Everything went wonderfully, right down to graduation, the speeches were amazing. And it was spectacular. And I just want to thank you. And it's obviously, we can point out, I'm going to miss it. So at least I have this. But I thank you all very much for educating my girls so nicely.
That's interesting. You're welcome.
Thanks. There's always a meeting.
Well, let her ask for a little while.
This is a much more pleasant meeting.
Yes, it is.
Thank you. So,
Okay. So, going to special services, the Board of Education approves the recommendations for services of the Committee on Special Education, sub-CSE 504 Committee, and Committee on Preschool Special Education for October, November, December 2014, and January, February, March, April, May, June, and July 2015, as detailed in Thursday.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. DeResta. Because this contains names of students, we're not allowed to discuss this in public. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Yeah. There is no one turn on the Special Education Service Report this month, so we're moving on to the business at hand. The Board of Education approved the renewal of student accident insurance policy with J.J. Stannis and Company for the 2015-2016 school year at an annual cost of $25,461.41, a decrease of $986.05 from last year, as detailed in the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. O'Hagan, second by Mr. Press. Are there any questions or comments on this?
The only thing I want to point out was that last year we had a decrease as well, so this is two decreases in a row.
Yes. Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves cell phone usage. The Board of Education approves the credit card annual report for 2014-2015 school year as detailed in the Thursday note.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this side?
Yes, there was zero.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Okay. And we're talking about doing something about that in the future. Right. All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the cell phone usage annual report for the 2014-2015 school year as detailed in the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Any questions or comments on this?
No.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the contract with Preferred Meals with contractor pricing at $1.49 for breakfast and $2.42 for lunch for the 2014-2015 school year, as detailed in the Thursday night.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Is that correct?
No.
2014.
Oh, no, it should be 1516.
1516.
Yeah.
Yeah, it says that on the backup material, it says 1516.
Yeah, the backup.
So it's just, yeah, it's just.
Okay, so this is 2015.
1516.
16. Okay. All those, so do we have to do any changes? All right, all those in favor?
Oh, sorry, questions.
Okay, you can go first.
Okay, so I just wanted to know why are we adding the breakfast part of it?
We're required by the state because we have a lunch program. We're required, we tried to get a waiver for a year.
Last year was the waiver.
Well, no, last year we started with the lunch program. We tried to get a waiver for our next school year for breakfast. They would not allow us to get a waiver.
Okay.
So I do have a question also. Are you going to be sending out a letter to parents about the breakfast program and?
We already sent letters out in the spring.
Oh, right, right, but I mean to let them, that was sort of like a survey letter.
It was a survey letter to see whether or not we would have to offer it in each individual building.
So now that we know that we are, when are we going to notify the parents? And how it's going to happen?
Right, so in the back-to-school letter, there'll be information there about the start time for breakfast and the end time for breakfast and the process for that.
We have back-to-school?
You get a pack?
I don't remember getting.
It's in the pile with the newsletter.
The teacher. I don't remember.
Yeah, from the teacher.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Teacher letter, teacher's name. Oh, you mean like the day before school?
No, that's a long.
That sounds like a day before school, but the teacher.
You get it on.
Yes, the week before, it's before Labor Day.
Yes.
It's last week in August.
Everyone waits.
We get like a day or two before school.
I was talking about with the teacher assignment, all that.
That's very, that's, one year we had to look on the door, remember that?
Right.
We didn't get it at all.
Because it was the.
Right.
I've always gotten mine in August.
But, so it won't be till a couple days before school that parents know about. Is breakfast going to affect dropping off your kids or, I mean, what parts is going to roll out?
Breakfast is going to start earlier. It's going to be 8:15 and go till 8:35.
Okay.
And so the kids who are opting for breakfast will be allowed to come in at 8:15, but they have to be there to eat breakfast. It's not daycare for, you know, half an hour. And that's something that we're going to be watching and monitoring.
So don't you think we should roll that out kind of soon so people can plan their work life around that? I would think parents need at least a couple weeks' notice.
We're still starting the program.
Yeah. I mean, we're still figuring this thing out. What?
We're still working on staff. We've got the time and.
So it might not be happening the first day of school?
No, it will happen the first day of school.
But I guess what Deb was saying, which I think I agree with her, is that, okay, so you sent out the survey that this could be coming, this could not be coming. We don't know, we've not received, as a parent, we've not received an announcement that this is actually taking place. So I guess, I mean, I have to agree with her, I think that you need to, you should have something going out prior to 2 days before you get your, when you get your assignment saying, you know, this is coming. I know that's additional postage and whatnot, but I think.
Well, it's additional postage and I don't know that we will be ready to do that, but we can certainly take that under advisement and see, you know, if we can.
Because I guess the other questions, okay, you send something out, you get a lot of questions and things like that.
If parents just stay notified a couple of days before school starts, I think you're going to get a lot of complaints about, why did I know about this 2 weeks ago? I could be taking the 820 trains to the 848 train, you know, I don't know.
And so I understand that.
Yeah.
But respectfully, it's not a before care program, so.
Well, that's not, my concern is that they may utilize it as a before care program.
Yeah.
And how are we going to handle that? Because then that will also affect the traffic in the morning.
Right, and staffing.
And staffing.
Right. And one of the things that, you know, we did, we've been talking about traffic and Mr. Randazzo and Dr. Draper went and did some survey of buildings and, you know, so we're working on that. We're working on the staffing of the breakfast program, you know.
You said 8:15?
Right. So there's still a lot to be done and we, you know, we're still working out the kinks of that. The other thing that you should know is that Dr. Draper will be visiting all of the buildings for breakfast and for lunch to check out quality of the food and the temperature and all of that, so. I know it's not the answer you want, but it's you know, we're still working on it.
Right.
The posting to staff of the program just went out yesterday.
I think, I mean, that you could at least kind of let people know it's kind of on the horizon, and maybe a quick add or something.
I was just.
Yeah, just to be like, hey, we're working on this, keep an eye out for it.
I do feel like the letter that we get, I get the letter in August, I get the third week in August, so what?
Liz, I have the two days before, right? Sometimes a day before.
We can see that Plaza mailed it out earlier, and that might help solve the problem.
All the different schools in the map.
Yes.
Paragraph in the letter.
Connected, we'll just switch up.
Oh, connected.
Connected via Facebook, I mean, you may not get everyone, but you'll get a lot less people. They know, oh, we've got to keep an eye out.
This is still being developed, something like that. All right, so are there any more questions or discussion on this item? Okay, so can we vote on it? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed, abstain? Okay, the Board of Education approves the renewal dental contract with Dentacare Delivery Systems, HealthPlex, through Fitz Harris and Company for the 2015-2016 school year, as detailed in Thursday evening.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Regan. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
Can I just ask one quick question? The three items on dental care, the three contracts, can you just, in very short, one sentence, what's the difference? What's?
Two, we self-insure, but they're different, there are three bargaining units that have three different contracts.
Okay, that's all I need to know.
So then, I just want to, so this one, the individual coverage didn't increase, and the family, it increased only 50 cents per month. So that's pretty good.
Yeah, good thing. Any other questions or comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the renewal of the dental contract with Ameritrust Life Insurance Company.
No, you skipped one.
Oh, there's checkoff 6.6. All right, the Board of Education approves the renewal of this district self-funded dental program with Fitz Harris and Company for the 2015-16 school year, as detailed in Thursday evening.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Regan. Any questions or comments on this item?
This one had no increases either.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, abstain, okay. Now we're number seven, the Board of Education approves the renewal of the dental contract with Ameritrust Life Insurance Company through Fitz Harris and Company for the 2015-2016 school year, as detailed in Thursday evening.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. Dressler. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
No increase here either.
All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education authorizes participation in the National School Lunch Program for the 2015-16 school year and approves the adoption of the policy statement, certification statement, news release, and application as detailed in the Thursday.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. O'Hagan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Press. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the Nassau BOCES letter of intent for 2015-16 services as detailed in Thursday.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposing? Abstain? Okay. The Board of Education approves the Nassau BOCES final AS7 agreement for the 2014-15 services as detailed on Thursday morning.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Neill. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
I guess just for the people in the audience who are like, what's an AS7? Maybe someone knows. Oh, so this is just the sort of the cost of the programs that we took advantage of for the past school year. Good BOCES, yeah.
Any other questions or comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the Nassau BOCES initial AS7 agreement for the 2015-16 services as detailed in Thursday noon.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. O'Hagan and second by Mr. Pless. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
I just want to say this actually represented a pretty significant reduction in costs for us. So it was over $1 million.
That's temporary.
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 That's right.
Yeah.
Because we have that.
Because technology's not included in that.
Okay, so it'll go up, but I mean our letter of intent is initial ASM. I mean, it'll change too.
Yeah, it changes.
Just what we did this.
Yeah, this is an estimate, really.
Right.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approved the 2013-14 Capital Improvement Program Phase 1 Change Order Number 1, window replacement at middle school in the amount of $2,000 as detailed in the first amendment. Moved by Mr. Pless.
Second.
Second by Mrs. DeRusco. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, the Board of Education approves the HVAC reconstruction contract bid to HVAC, the lowest responsible bidder, in the amount of $89,500, and the masonry reconstruction bid to A1 Construction, the lowest responsible bidder, in the amount of $18,950, as detailed in the third email.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Pless, second. Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
I did ask questions just about what this, what all of this is, like what is the HVAC reconstruction that's happening?
Middle school's going to have a refurbishment of their HVAC system in the auditorium. And the masonry part is all the boys locking because the whole has some issues with water being ignited.
So HVAC in the auditorium at middle school is just heat.
We'll wait for the bond issue.
Any other questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves payment of the health and welfare services contracts for 28 students with the Manhasset Union Free School District, St. Mary's High School and Elementary School for the 2014-15 school year in the amount of $832,946.94 per student for a total of $23,322.32 as detailed on Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. Haney.
Second.
Second by Mr. Pless. Any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the tuition contract for the special education of two non-resident students from Malvern Union School District for the 2015-16 school year as detailed on the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Pless.
Second.
Second by Mrs. Haney. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the transportation contract extensions for veterans, LEE, First Student, Suburban, Acme, Bowman, and Veterans Choice. Mm-hmm. Veterans Choice?
Not on the
agreement.
For the 2015-16 school year as detailed in Thursday night.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Pless.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this side?
I think we should make note that the increase, it's a 0% increase across the board for all of these, so we'll be in the same rates for 15-16 as we did for 14-50, which has the consultant who came in and told us in very good ways. So,
yeah.
Excellent.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. The Board of Education approves the agreement with Milnet Interpreter Services to provide sign language interpreting services for the 2015-16 school year as detailed in the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Pless.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this side? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Pless.
Aye.
That's okay. Just want to make sure. The Board of Education approves the agreement with IVER Translations to provide translation and interpreting services as needed for the 2015-16 school year as detailed on Thursday night.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. O'Hagan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Pless. Are there any questions or comments on this item? I just wanted to ask publicly because I had a conversation with you a little bit about this. So will the service be available to us to send some of our
communications from the school, like if we want to translate from English to Spanish or other. It will. We have internal capacity to do this, but this is a professional translating and interpreting company, so it gives us the option of doing it that way. But yes, for major mailings and things like that, we can go to Ivory and do that. And sort of on a side note, one of the nice things about our website is that the entire website, at a click of a button, translates into different languages. So you can, if you're a Spanish-speaking family, you can click on translate to Spanish. If you're Haitian Creole, you can say translate to, to Haitian Creole. That is one of the options.
No.
You have to be able to get that thing. So you gotta know enough to.
Okay, are there any other questions or comments on this? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the contract for three students attending Harmony Heights School for the 2015-16 school year in the amount of $26,456 per student for a total of $71,368 as detailed in the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. O'Hagan, second by Mr. Press. Are there any questions or comments on this item? Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. The Board of Education approves the contract for one student attending Ferncliff Manor for the retarded for the 2015-16 school year in the amount of $55,402 per student as detailed in the 13th.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press, second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this item? And yes, that's the name of the school. Mm-hmm. I didn't make that up, so all right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. The Board of Education approves the contract with Amanda McCarthy to provide student training and behavior consultative services for the 2015-16 school year as detailed in the Thursday
note. So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press, second by Mrs. O'Leary. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor? The Board of Education approves the contract with Ms. Lydia Swinton to provide Polish evaluation services for the 2015-16 school year as detailed in the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. O'Hagan, second by Mr. Press. Are there any questions or comments on this? Is there, if we have a person in the past for Polish?
I don't know if we've had in the past, but we do have Polish speaking.
Okay. Yeah, it said there were no services provided last year.
Okay.
But perhaps
All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the contract with Ms. Gina Castaldo to provide professional development services not to exceed 28 days for a total expenditure of $33,600 for the 2015-16 school year as detailed in the Thursday mail.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press. Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
I have a question just to better understand. So, but it relates to the one that we didn't approve yet. The Gina Castaldo versus Carolla. Mm-hmm. What's the distinction? One has 28 days versus one has 4 days.
The ones that are the lower days are actually some curriculum writing. If you want to explain something?
Yeah, the bullets were the same.
Gina and Amber are a team. And based on the fact that we have 5 elementary buildings, one person couldn't service all 5, so they, according to their calendar and their commitments are the school districts.
Okay.
We split the days based on their availability.
Okay.
So, and they're doing basically, they're both doing professional development. Tina's doing it in 4 buildings, and Mark's doing it in 1. And they're both working on curriculum writing also, but they're a team.
Okay.
So we can set the contracts for each.
Any other questions or comments, Council? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the contract with Ms. Gina Castaldo for the revision of the existing reading and writing curriculum, not to exceed 7.5 days for the total expenditure of $7,500 for the 2015-16 school year as detailed in the Thursday.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the contract with Ms. Erica Caparelli to to provide professional development services not to exceed 7 days for a total of $8,400 for the 2015-16 school year, as detailed in the urgent memo.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. Sullivan, second by Mr. Press. Are there any questions or comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the contract with Ms. Erica Pacquiao for revision of the existing reading and writing curriculum not to exceed 7.5 days for a total expenditure of $7,500 for the 2015-16 school year, as detailed in the urgent memo. Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves a contract for reimbursement to a parent with a mileage to and from and out of district placement for which the parent is entitled to reimbursement, and move the district's applying and payment for a bus for this transportation as detailed on Thursday.
So
moved by Mrs. O'Hagan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Buss. Any questions or comments on this?
Just one question. If that's been around for a while, and I haven't seen that before. So the parent is choosing to drive the child?
Michelle?
The parent is choosing to drive the child, and the district, they can claim mileage?
I think it's also if they go there for CSE, through the residence where the child is at, they can claim mileage.
There is a provision that allows to be able to bill us for their expense. I don't know if their student enrollment program is.
Okay, you're not talking about daily. You're talking about they may claim it. If a child is in a residential placement, for instance, then they go to visit the child. They can claim. Okay, I get it.
Any other questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education accepts with thanks a donation of $3,000 for two smart televisions, two Wi-Fi enabled keyboards, and two TV parts from the Meadow Site-Based Committee to be used at Meadow School as detailed in the Thursday morning.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments from the side? I would just say thank you.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education accepts with thanks a donation of $1,000 from Northrop Grumman from a grant application to be used for the STEM Academy in the 2015-16 school year, as detailed in the Thursday morning.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Any questions or comments?
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the disposition of obsolete TVs, VCRs, carts, and DVD player from Lennox School that are no longer functional per state rules and regulations as detailed in the Thursday meeting.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Cox.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Any comments or questions? And no, we will not be selling the truck.
Where will you be selling them? Just in case someone was interested.
No. Won't be any of that in a VCR.
I do have videos too. All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the disposition of obsolete foreign language textbooks that are no longer useful per state rules and regulations as detailed in the Thursday meeting.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. DeResta. Are there any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the disposition of obsolete math and social studies textbooks from Brookside School that are no longer useful for state rules and regulations as detailed in the Thursday meeting.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. DeResta, second by Mr. Press. Any questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
The Board of Education approves the disposition of obsolete equipment that is broken beyond repair and have been stripped of any useful parts per state rules and regulations as detailed in the Thursday meeting. Moved by Mr. Price.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments on this item?
So the hard drives were stripped from all of them. They will go to a shredding company. Mm-hmm. The other parts of the equipment go to a recycling company.
Any other questions or comments on this item? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. The Board of Education approves the use of facilities report for August 2015 through June 2016 as detailed in the Thursday Hill.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Press.
Second.
Second by Mrs. O'Hagan. Are there any questions or comments? I'm looking, we don't need to do something here for minutes on Sunday? This is Saturday, Sunday for the policy, the minutes are there. We do, right? So, okay, I need a motion to table action on this.
Why don't you just do it as amended and we'll take this off and we'll put it on the next one. That's why we can approve the others.
Okay.
So we're gonna take the, well, we need to sign.
Did we not suspend it for that?
Did we suspend it for that already?
Are we able?
I think.
I know it was for the calendar year, 2000.
Okay, so all right, then we're good.
So I think we're good.
All right, then I just wanted to double check. Okay, thank you. All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay. Is there anything on the other?
So I just wanna make sure in terms of the board priorities, that discussion happens tomorrow.
Where that's going to be happening, which we can't specifically talk about board business. So we're gonna have training on what to do in terms of writing board priorities.
Okay.
And then we'll come back to what we're actually gonna do with this.
Like September or.
Okay.
No, we're looking to do that before the opening of school, and that's why we put together a board meeting on.
Is that part of the 24?
The 17?
Did you say that was 17?
I just said, I didn't even know we were having any number of 17.
No, that was in the Friday mailing.
Was it?
Yeah, it just came out on this Friday, right, this one.
Does that happen for you?
No.
Great.
I'm good. I could do the 17.
You do the 17?
I cannot do the 24.
Well, the only problem with not is that we're gonna start school without priority.
I mean, I don't wanna do that again. We did it last year. We've done it the last 2 years now.
Principals might just send something out like that, so.
So what do we recommend?
Well, I mean, we can do the meeting on the 17th.
Oh, I was just gonna say, don't let it, yeah, as long as it's a quorum, and I'll try to make it, you know, depends on the time and whatever, but, yeah, don't worry about it.
I mean, if it's worked on the 17th, then it could be presented again on the 24th, even though that's a.
Oh, yeah.
No, well, yeah.
So we have everybody between the 2 days.
Yeah.
So if we could really work on it on the 17th, and then, no, the 24th is during the.
Okay.
So that's, it's meant to be a very short meeting, so. Okay, so.
The 24th is during the day.
Yeah, that's the one that's during the day after the new teacher orientation.
17th is in the evening.
Right.
Okay, are we good?
That was here, the 24th.
And the 17th.
The high school is here.
No, it's here.
It's here, but it's not in here because the.
Well, the meeting will take place, yeah.
And I'm with the new teachers right after, so.
We'll bring the meter to the gym.
Okay, so anything else I need? Okay.
Wait, those are both open meetings, essentially the 24th.
17th and 24th, but the 24th is meant to be a very short open, except the PAR, which is the purpose of the CSE.
Right, I'm just letting the district board know that they both have the.
Oh.
I was looking for my important reason for that.
Awesome.
What's up, good?
All right, so, before I open the floor for our second comment section, upcoming important dates, BOE, BEA meeting, Monday.
So it's a Monday.
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 August 17th. Special Board of Education meeting Monday, August 24th, 9:30 a.m. Both meetings taking place at the district office. First day of school for the little kiddies is Wednesday, September 2nd. School is closed for Labor Day on Monday, September 7th. And our next regular scheduled Board of Education meeting is on Wednesday, September 9th. Here at the district office.
The next one's actually a board assignment.
No. All right, so that's that. Does anybody, all two of you, have any questions? All right.
I have a motion. I just gave you the high side. It's not allowed. You can ask you questions on the way home.
I move.
You too, John. No.
I guess second to.
Second.
Second? All right, Mr. Hagan. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. 9:47? That's 9:47, right?
I think it may be that I remember when we all was and I changed it.
I think that definitely is a, yes.